Southeastern champion.
Adjust your sets. Do not change your television screens. Yes, that is Toby Farley, and yes, that is the Mountain Empire Championship. We're here right now coming to you from Princeton, West Virginia, where Toby Farley just made short work of notorious Nick Hammonds. And the reason we're coming to you right now is we got a message for you. Jax Dane, by the time this airs on television, it will be the morning before Civic Auditorium. It'll be morning before your final day as NWA World's Heavyweight Champion. I know you're sitting there wherever you're at right now, and I know you're watching this. So let me tell you what to do. First off, go get that belt. He needs to get the belt. Needs to look at it. He needs to do some soul searching. Then he needs to clean the belt up real nice. Then you need to get in your vehicle, your truck. You need to drive to Kingsport. And you need to get ready. Jax, we know exactly how big you are. Toby knows exactly how tough you are, how strong you are, and how mean you are.
And I don't care.
He doesn't care because Toby Farley is just as mean. He's just as strong, and he's just as hungry. That's the difference. He's got one bit of gold right now. He's coming for it. Jax Dane! You are the top dog in the National Wrestling Alliance. That makes you the greatest wrestler in the world today. But you've never been in the ring with Toby Farley. Get ready, Jax. You got a few more hours of that belt. I'd use them wisely.
Hello, I'm Ken Daffron.
And I'm Gail. We're owners of Dalton Direct Carpets in Kingsport.
We're featuring Caress Carpet from Shaw Industries. Carpet's so soft it makes you want to take your shoes off to play or even take a nap on the floor. Financing is available. That's at Dalton Direct Carpets, Bloomingdale Road in Kingsport.
Are you experiencing neck pain, back pain, or headaches? Muse Family Chiropractic can help. Dr. Alan Muse provides a complete assessment using state-of-the-art technology to determine the cause of the pain and offers advanced treatments to help you find your way to a healthier, pain-free life. At Muse Family Chiropractic, we provide chiropractic care for the whole family, from newborns to great-grandparents, and we accept most insurances.
At Muse Family Chiropractic, you're not just a patient, you're family.
Call us today at 247-5000.
Tennessee Title Owns.
How's it going?
It's going. How can I help you today?
Well, I have some car issues. I could really use the loan. So.
Man, what happened?
Funny, I was just driving along and a horse just came out of the sky. So.
Get the cash you need fast with Tennessee Title Loans. Located on East Stone Drive in Kingsport.
Attention, nonprofit organizations. Are you tired of selling candy bars and candles and not able to raise the funds you would like to? For the past 10 years, NWA Smoky Mountain has raised lots of money for many great nonprofit organizations. And you can bring the same fundraising technique to your event. For more information, please call area code 423-773-5449 or area code 423-631-9110. Can't get enough of NWA Smoky Mountain? Do you enjoy watching NWA Smoky Mountain TV and want to see more of your favorite stars? Then I have good news for you. Our website, NWASmokyMountain.com, is the place you need to be for all the exclusive news, exclusive matches, exclusive blogs by your favorite NWA Smoky Mountain stars, and much more.
We'll see if Axton Ray can rally here.
Fans definitely behind Axton Ray here tonight.
Axton quickly becoming one of the more popular men on the NWA Smoky Mountain roster as he lights up the champion with some forearm shots. Fires him off. What's the challenger got in mind? Double sledge there. Axton's feeling it. Nice clothesline. The champion is reeling here. But he's not a lot of time left. Splash in the corner. Into a neck breaker. Nice combination of moves by Axton Ray. Is it going to be enough to put the champion away? There's a cover.
Oh, not quite enough, but he did think to hook that leg.
Solid strategy there. Both men showing the effects. This has been a very fast-paced match. They've been going at a breakneck speed from the opening bell, and it's not slowed down for 8 minutes now. 2 minutes just to go in this 10-minute time limit match. Kick them off the ropes. Spine buster by Axton Ray.
Big spine buster.
Oh, Jordan Cage able to get a shoulder up. Another very close pin attempt there by Axton Ray. He might be thinking at this point, what have I got to do to put the champion away and get that TV title? What's he going for here? Nope. Jordan Cage able to counter. Nice sidekick to the solar plexus by the champion. And he's got him hooked up. Some of that patented Jordan Cage offense right there. What's he got in mind here? Broken picture.
That could be enough right there, putting many of men away with that.
Could be enough to rearrange the facial structure of Axton Ray, but he kicks out. He kicks out. A lot of resilience by both men in this match, Coop.
Yeah, Axton Ray showing that he didn't just get this match, he earns this match. He deserves to be here. One minute.
Less than 1 minute to go here. Jordan Cage not really following up with any urgency.
Well, he does know he has the champion's advantage
he
now.
Absolutely
he knows there's
does.
A minute left. Doesn't matter to him now if he gets the pinfall or makes it through the time limit because time limit draw, he keeps his title.
Axton kicks him off. Look out. Cross body from Axton Ray. And thought we were going to see a new champion. 30 seconds remain in this match. Is somebody going to be able to pull out a big maneuver here to get the win? Or is Jordan Cage going to go the distance here with Axton Ray? Axton reverses the Irish whip. Oh, Jordan Cage countered with the big boot coming in. Wait a minute. DDT by Axton Ray. What's he going for here? Axton should be going for a pin. Missile drop kick. Oh, but that's it.
Oh,
Axton Ray was going for that missile drop kick of his. Some of his sick best offense that he's got, but he hits it right as time expires.
That we have the official announcement of a time limit draw. But
Axton Ray goes the distance with Jordan Cage here. Jordan Cage, I'm going to say, escapes as champion. I really thought that missile dropkick had Jordan Cage down for the count.
Yeah, quite possibly. I don't think we've seen the end of this one either, John Morehouse.
We'll see what's going to happen here. Jordan Cage, in my opinion, should be thankful he's leaving here with his television title reign, that picture-perfect reign of his still intact. I know what, Jordan Cage had his hand raised. This match is a draw.
Yeah, but he does return
the
title.
Demanded that the referee raise his hand there. The ego of Jordan Cage in full effect. And look at, wait a minute. Jordan Cage offering some respect here to Axton Ray. We're going to see a handshake.
A little bit out of character there for him, saying he respects him.
Jordan Cage offering the handshake here, showing respect to this young competitor. There it is. It's great sportsmanship here between these two men.
Dylan Sizemore seems a little bit confused by this.
Oh, wait a minute. Well, there's the real Jordan Cage right there.
Yeah, that blow was definitely south of the border.
Definitely south of the border. Definitely uncalled for after the match. He lures Axton Ray in feint and sportsmanship and respect. But Jordan Cage doesn't know anything about sportsmanship and respect. And now,
we've seen this before. No, don't do this.
This move is illegal. It's fuzzy 8x10. Don't do it. No!
It's completely uncalled for.
Now you play the champ's music.
It is.
Jordan Cage demanded his music be played. We've seen Jordan Cage's true colors for sure here. Axton Ray might need some medical attention.
Definitely, definitely. He's laid out in the ring.
Well, I hope Jordan Cage is proud of himself. I'm sure he is, but he's got nothing to be proud about, in my opinion.
To not a chance to prove once again why the agency is what we say we are. That is the best around. Picture perfect Jordan Cage, NWA Smoky Mountain television champion, rides in with the belt, and he's going to ride out with the belt. Axton Ray, don't get me wrong. You're good. You're fantastic. You're a great.
Let's don't go that far.
Okay.
Let's don't go that far.
He's good. We'll give him that. We'll give him he's good.
Lowercase good.
No capital G, just a little G with a little spinny tail on the bottom. You're good. You're good. Best part about you, that missile dropkick, it's dangerous. It's dangerous.
I would have kicked out.
Let me finish my statement. The missile dropkick is dangerous, but it's no fuzzy 8x10. Axton Ray, when you step into the ring tonight, once again, you lasted 10 minutes. That's an accomplishment. My hat's off to you. Tonight, 15 minutes, Jordan Cage breaks your neck. Tonight, 15 minutes, Jordan Cage ends your career. Tonight, 15 minutes, Jordan Cage puts you in a wheelchair permanently. Tonight, 15 minutes, Jordan Cage leaves with the Smoky Mountain television title. Tonight, the agency continues to make wrestling great again.
And Axton, it ain't going to last 15 minutes. You're more like 5 minutes. And why? Because we're the agency. And that's picture perfect.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, Encore 2016, from the Civic Auditorium in Kingsport, Tennessee, Axton Ray, you've got another chance at that NWA Smoky Mountain TV title held by Jordan Cage. We saw last week your first match ended in a 10-minute time limit draw. Tonight, Axton, you and Jordan Cage rematch, but this time a 15-minute time limit. What are your thoughts?
Last weekend, I got an honor of a lifetime, the NWA television title. But you know what, Jordan Cage, you couldn't get the job done. You just couldn't get the job done in 10 minutes. This week, they gave me 15 minutes. In 15 minutes, I will do to you what you could not do to me. I am more hungry and more focused than I have ever been. Be ready, Jordan.
Ken Daffron.
And I'm Gail. We're owners of Dalton Direct Carpets in Kingsport.
We're featuring Caress Carpet from Shaw Industries. Carpet's so soft it makes you want to take your shoes off to play or even take a nap on the floor. Financing is available. That's at Dalton Direct Carpets, Bloomingdale Road in Kingsport.
Are you experiencing neck pain, back pain, or headaches? Muse Family Chiropractic can help. Dr. Alan Muse provides a complete assessment using state-of-the-art technology to determine the cause of the pain and offers advanced treatments to help you find your way to a healthier, pain-free life. At Muse Family Chiropractic, we provide chiropractic care for the whole family, from newborns to great-grandparents, and we accept most insurances.
At Muse Family Chiropractic, you're not just a patient, you're family.
Call us today at 247-5000.
Hey, welcome to Tennessee Title Loans.
How's it going?
It's going. How can I help you today?
Well, I mean, I have some car issues. I could really use the loan. So,
man, what happened?
Funny, I was just driving along and a horse just came out of the sky. So,
get the cash you need fast with Tennessee Title Loans. Located on East Stone Drive in Kingsport.
Attention, nonprofit organizations. Are you tired of selling candy bars and candles and not able to raise the funds you would like to? For the past 10 years, NWA Smoky Mountain has raised lots of money for many great nonprofit organizations. And you can bring the same fundraising technique to your event. For more information, please call area code 423-773-5449 or area code 423-631-9110. Can't get enough of NWA Smoky Mountain? Do you enjoy watching NWA Smoky Mountain TV and want to see more of your favorite stars? Then I have good news for you. Our website, NWASmokyMountain.com, is the place you need to be for all the exclusive news, exclusive matches, exclusive blogs by your favorite NWA Smoky Mountain stars, and much more.
All right, tag team action, a rematch from the finale, Mike Cooper. We saw these two teams, the Heat Seekers, Sigmund and Elliott Russell, against the Hardliners, Jeff Connolly and Brian Montgomery. Heat Seekers won the match, but they pinned Brian Montgomery, who was the illegal man at the time. Heat Seekers petitioned NWA Smoky Mountain promoter Tony Gibbons for this rematch. It has been granted, clearly, and this duo from Chaos insists they're going to come out with the victory this time.
That's exactly right. They are claiming that, you know, they may have been pinned, but they didn't really lose the match because it wasn't the legal man in the ring. But now they got their chance to show what they've got tonight and see if they can actually get the victory.
Yeah, the Hardliners definitely in a foul mood heading into this one. After that result, a match where they felt they were cheated. Jeff Connolly still a little sour after having his head shaved a couple of months ago. And they were greeted with the usual Jeff Connolly toilet paper shower.
Yes, as he
came in, which is one of those things you need to witness in person. So we encourage all NWA Smoky Mountain fans to join us at the Civic Auditorium, and you too can throw toilet paper at Jeff Connolly. Elliott Russell, meanwhile, firing off a nice cross body there.
Nice headlock takeover.
The two younger competitors on either side of this matchup. The Elliott Russell, at this point, with all the matches that he's been in and the roads he's traveled, really carries himself like a veteran in about every sense of the word, Coop.
That's exactly right. He may not have been around that long, but he's been around a lot. He's got a lot of experience, a lot of ring time, and being around Sigmund all the time like he is, them being tag team partners, he is seasoned far beyond his years.
Knee to the solar plexus there by Montgomery. May have even been a little bit low, but Russell rallies back from it nicely with a nice little side headlock takeover.
Working that same maneuver over and over again, isolating the body part. Montgomery has reversed that, and then another reverser.
Nice counter by Russell there, and Judas the Mad Hatter doesn't like it. Of course, anyone that goes against Chaos, you got to work against that numbers game. You see the 3 seconds there at ringside, Judas the Mad Hatter, Travis Dykes, and Onslaught. There's just one referee to keep track of all three men, and it's a challenge to be sure.
Oh, absolutely. The numbers game is always in their advantage. Now we see Sigmund taking over.
The wrestling extraordinaire Sigmund has held every championship in NWA Smoky Mountain except that Southeastern title, which is currently held by Jason Kincaid. Sigmund tying up the arm there, going for the fingers. Two of the best technical wrestlers you're going to find going head-to-head here, Coop, Jeff Connolly and Sigmund.
Well, that's exactly right. Two very fine MAC technicians, very tough individuals. Love to see these two men go at it. It's always, always exciting.
I remember a European rules match between these two from several years ago that was a sight to see. And now Sigmund working over that left arm of Jeff Connolly. Looking to the corner. Oh, headbutt. Hardest head in the sport down across the bicep of Jeff Connolly.
Yeah, that was like having a baseball bat slam across that bicep.
Now Russell coming in. Nice teamwork, as you would expect from a duo that is the former NWA World Tag Team Champions.
That's exactly right, and given the opportunity, they'll be a two-time NWA Tag Team Champions.
Yeah, they would like nothing better than to regain those titles. Connolly rolls through. That's a reversal there, and a handful of hair. Connolly not afraid to take some shortcuts. When you mix Jeff Connolly's technical ability with his willingness to break the rules, it just makes him that much more dangerous, in my opinion.
Very much so. A lot of people break the rules out of desperation of not having the skill level they need to get the job done. Jeff Connolly does it just because he enjoys it. He has the skill level to get any job done at any time. He just, if he sees the opportunity to break the rules, he'll take it.
Connolly's in a bad spot right now. As Sigmund measuring him. Double axe handle down across that arm. Trying to really just take away that left arm of Jeff Connolly here. And got him isolated. Wait a minute. You saw that Onslaught and Travis Dykes both trying to reach in and trip up the wrestling extraordinaire there.
And Sigmund controlling that arm. And here you see the Heat Seekers doing what they do best. Quick in and out tag. Superb tag team.
Yeah, we've seen six or seven or eight exchanges already between the former world champions.
And you see here, going after the exact same body part, just picking the man apart. Now that shows a lot of maturity on the part of Elliot Russell to go right back after the same body part that Sigmund was working on. Shades of the Anderson there. Pick a body part, break it down, make it useless.
I've heard Elliot Russell compared to Barry Windham. I've heard him compared to the late, great Brad Armstrong. That is the first Anderson's comparison, but here it is definitely accurate when you see him working over that arm.
Yes, he does remind me a lot of Barry Windham, but, yes, that's a trademark of the Andersons to work on one body part and just break it down over a match. And here it shows a very good sign of a very good tag team that they're going after that arm and just staying on that one particular body part. Because if they take that arm away from Jeff Connolly, they're going to take at least half of his offense away.
Trying to trip up Sigmund again there. Boy, the hardliners requested this match, you know, this rematch, but it might be a case of be careful what you wish for at this point because it's been pretty much all Heat Seekers so far. Connolly really has been getting worked over. Off the ropes, what's going on here? Wait a minute, Sigmund through the ropes! Big suicide dive into both Travis Dykes and Onslaught. Crash landing out on the floor. Elliot Russell is in. Elliot Russell, not the legal man. He's working over Connolly nonetheless. I don't know if the referee's going to allow that exchange or not. Meanwhile, Travis Dykes and Onslaught have been wiped out. Covered by Russell. Only a two count.
Well, there's only so many times you can do something like grab the leg of Sigmund before he's going to retaliate. I think they just found that out the hard way.
About 600 or so pounds of chaos that Sigmund wiped out with that suicide dive as Sigmund comes in with the headbutt. And chaos is really in a bad way now, seems like. All the momentum in the Heat Seekers' favor.
Absolutely.
They have been dominating this match, especially Jeff Connolly, who might be looking for the exit door at this point here soon.
Very desperately does need to make that tag.
I don't think he'll be making it with his left arm at this point.
No, I don't think he'll be doing too much.
Another hair-assisted takedown there, and finally Connolly able to make the tag. We'll see if the hardliners can get some momentum going here. And Montgomery just a measured kick to just straight to the face of the Southern Psycho. Excuse me.
Now you see Montgomery taking over on Elliot Russell. He's pulled the referee away.
Oh, wait a minute. There you see Onslaught and Travis Dykes. They've recovered from that suicide dive and basically a three-on-one attack there. Typical chaos tactics.
Big whip across the ring.
Sort of seeing the fruition of Judas the Mad Hatter's plan. He's really reshaped chaos in his own image here recently. Addie Montgomery and Onslaught both As Montgomery with the cover, only a one count.
Making the fast tag.
Might have given Connell a little more breathing room or, you know, recovery time. He was in there for a long time isolated, getting that arm worked over, but now using that knee. You see that knee brace?
And he's not afraid at all to use that knee brace as a weapon.
You have felt that knee brace as a weapon, Mike Cooper.
Yeah.
It's not pleasant. And an abdominal claw by Connolly. Working over the ribs. Clubbing blows down across the sternum. This crowd trying to get behind Elliot Russell here as Connolly measures him. Elbow down across Russell. Goes for the cover. Gets a two count.
Ken Daffron.
And I'm Gail. We're owners of Dalton Direct Carpets in Kingsport.
We're featuring Caress Carpet from Shaw Industries. The carpet's so soft it makes you want to take your shoes off to play or even take a nap on the floor. Financing is available. That's at Dalton Direct Carpets, Bloomingdale Road in Kingsport.
Are you experiencing neck pain, back pain, or headaches? Muse Family Chiropractic can help. Dr. Alan Muse provides a complete assessment using state-of-the-art technology to determine the cause of the pain and offers advanced treatments to help you find your way to a healthier, pain-free life. At Muse Family Chiropractic, we provide chiropractic care for the whole family, from newborns to great-grandparents, and we accept most insurances.
At Muse Family Chiropractic, you're not just a patient, you're family.
Call us today at 247-5000.
Tennessee Title Loans.
How's it going?
It's going. How can I help you today?
Well, I mean, I have some car issues. I could really use the loan. So,
man, what happened?
Funny, I was just driving along and a horse just came out of the sky. So,
get the cash you need fast with Tennessee Title Loans. Located on East Stone Drive in Kingsport.
Attention, nonprofit organizations. Are you tired of selling candy bars and candles and not able to raise the funds you would like to? For the past 10 years, NWA Smoky Mountain has raised lots of money for many great nonprofit organizations. And you can bring the same fundraising technique to your event. For more information, please call area code 423-773-5449 or area code 423-631-9110. Can't get enough of NWA Smoky Mountain? Do you enjoy watching NWA Smoky Mountain TV and want to see more of your favorite stars? Then I have good news for you. Our website, NWASmokyMountain.com, is the place you need to be for all the exclusive news, exclusive matches, exclusive blogs by your favorite NWA Smoky Mountain stars, and much more.
And Russell firing back on Connolly, but Connolly cuts him off, backs him into the ropes, shoots him off, ducks the clothesline, comes back with an attempt at a, and he gets it, a sunset slip, 1-2.
Oh, I thought that might have done it. Russell very close to winning the match, and a nice drop kick. It was like a kind of single leg drop kick, but caught Russell flushing the side of the head, cover, only a two count. Definitely rattled the Southern Psycho, that's for sure. You don't see many drop kicks from Jeff Connolly. Pulling out all the stops. Chaos wants this win bad, especially after what happened last month. These two want to stake their claim as a force to be reckoned with in the tag division, not just in NWA Smoky Mountain, but the entire National Wrestling Alliance.
Reverse chin lock there.
You see a good look at Onslaught. The whole Chaos crew there.
Crowd definitely behind the Heat Seekers here, chanting for Elliott, trying to get him up on his feet. He's firing back, hits the ropes, but no, right into an elbow.
Nice savvy there by Montgomery, almost lured Russell in there, caught him with that elbow. Only able to get another two count. Chaos just cannot put Elliott Russell down for the three.
Well, it's definitely going to take a whole lot to put either of these men down. They're doing the smart thing, though, by doing the constant in and out tagging, so neither one of them really gets too tired, while at the same time absolutely wearing Elliott out here. Another knee to the back, cutting off the ring, keeping him in their own corner. That way he cannot get close enough to make a tag. You see the referee making sure the man is able to continue, asking him, do you want to give it up? Elliott Russell's like, absolutely not.
No, Russell's not gonna submit. I think you'd have to make him pass out before he would tap out. Montgomery back in. Nice teamwork there. A little bit of a Russian leg sweep drop kick combination by the hardliners. Is that going to be enough? 1-2? No.
Very, very close, but not quite enough.
Montgomery is frustrated. Another pin attempt. Just trying to wear to every one of these pin attempts that the hardliners make, Coop. It just forces Elliott Russell to expend that much more energy.
That's exactly right. And then the more they pound on the man and go after these pin attempts, the more energy he's expending.
Russell might have had it there in that reversal into the inside cradle. Russell gets him hooked up. Possible backslide here. He's got him down. Is this going to do it?
Almost.
Montgomery. Nice drop kick by Montgomery.
Good presence of mind of Brian Montgomery there to hit.
Wait
that
a minute.
Sigma's
got the referee distracted. Montgomery has Russell pinned.
Smart.
I believe Russell might have been down for the three count there, but the referee didn't see it. A little bit of those Heat Seekers tactics of old there, and it worked.
Yeah, very smart thinking on Sigmund's part there. He knew Elliott was in trouble, so he distracted the referee just long enough to make sure Elliott didn't get pinned.
That's going to add to the frustration of the hardliners there after making, pin attempt after pin attempt, but unable to put Russell away. Seemingly had him down, but Sigmund had the referee distracted. Is now Connolly tying up Russell in a submission hold here. Russell trying to fight it. He's got to the ropes. Referee needs to break up this hold. Connolly cuts him off with a knee right to the ribs. It's going to suck the wind out of you. Now Connolly
spits right at Sigmund.
Complete disrespect by the closer. An illegal exchange by the hardliners.
Referee doesn't see it because he's busy trying to put Sigmund out of the ring. But absolutely illegal switch. Sigmund losing his cool there for just a moment. Now Elliott in a very bad way. Needs to make that tag desperately.
Almost a modified camel clutch here by Montgomery. It's been a real battle back and forth here in this rematch between the Heat Seekers and the Hardliners. Such an important match for both teams, and another hair-assisted takedown.
He's going to go for another pin attempt.
Going to do it? No. Trying to wear Russell down with every pin attempt they make. He's trying to get to the corner and tag Sigmund, getting so close, but Montgomery able to cut off his advance. Nice running knee by Montgomery. Folds up Russell. That might do it.
That could
be
all.
Is that
going
to do one? No, Sigmund with the save.
Sigmund doing the smart thing there, making sure that there was no chance of that pinfall being made there.
Meanwhile, I think we've seen another behind-the-back exchange by the hardliners. And now Connolly putting those submission skills to use.
Yeah, that brace in your back doesn't help things either.
Absolutely not. You got that, just that metal digging into your spine and your ribs.
And he's digging his fingers into the corner of the mouth of Elliot Russell. Just being totally brutal here, methodical in his dissection of Elliot Russell.
Russell really has been getting worked over here. We'll see if the hardliners are able to put this away. What's Connolly got in mind here? Russell off. Oh, nice reversal into the neck breaker by Russell. Elliot Russell with a big counter. And is that going to be enough for him to get to the corner and tag in Sigmund? The wrestling extraordinaire is itching to get back into this match.
And Elliot definitely needs to make this tag at this point. He's totally spent. He's worn out. He's hurting. He needs to make this tag. Now, Jeff Connolly first to get up. Goes and makes a tag, but no.
And Sigmund's in. Sigmund is in, and he levels Montgomery with a big running clothesline. Sigmund, a house of fire as he tags into this match. Sigmund with a nice drop kick of his own. Just taunting Montgomery a little bit here. A suplex into a slam. Sigmund, is that going to do it? No.
Close, but not quite there.
Oh, Montgomery, nice wherewithal there to cut off Sigmund with that jawbreaker. What's he got in mind here? Sigmund able to block. German suplex! Montgomery taking the trip to Suplex City there. And now Sigmund scaling up to the top. Might be looking for that flying headbutt. Oh, but Connolly over to cut him off. Sigmund just drops down on that turnbuckle chain. And Connolly directing traffic here a little bit. He got in mind, Connolly, not the legal man.
Big superplex.
It's going to take a big toll on both men. This match is broken down, Coop. I think the referee losing a little bit of control. Montgomery, who is the legal man now, he's up top. Measuring Sigmund. Comes up empty on the splash. And Sigmund tags in Russell. We'll see how much Elliott's been able to recover here. Other three men in this match are down and hurting. Signature double team offense by the Heat Seekers. Is that going to be enough? Dude, no, Connolly with a save. Coop, I thought that was going to do it. That suplex netbreaker combo. Heat Seekers have won several matches with that. Jeff Connolly able to make the save and now getting pulled to the outside by Sigmund.
Referee is over with.
Referee trying to break that
Jeff
up.
Connolly and Sigmund.
Trying to break up that combination.
Elliot
Russell,
Russell
with a roll up.
Oh!
Onslaught just clock Russell in the head with Judas the Mad Hatter's cane.
Shot straight
Russell
to
might
the
be
face.
Unconscious. The hardliners have done it. That shot with the cane. Chaos and the hardliners have defeated the former NWA World Tag Team Champions. Wait a minute here, Coop, wait a minute. Judas was celebrating on the outside and had his back turned to the Heat Seekers, which is never a good idea. And now Sigmund's got him. Oh, Sigmund's got the cane to kind of fend him off. The leader of chaos going for a ride on the Oklahoma Stampede from Russell. Flying headbutt on Judas.
They may have won this battle, but they're surely losing the war.
It's going to spoil the victory party for the Mad Hatter and for Chaos. Hardliners win the match, but Heat Seekers with some revenge is beating down Judas the Mad Hatter here at the Civic Auditorium. Goodness. So it's one win apiece for these teams, and Coop, I got a feeling there's still a score to settle between the Heat Seekers and the Hardliners.
Absolutely. We have not seen the end of this.
I'm Ken Deffren.
And I'm Gail. We're owners of Dalton Direct Carpets in Kingsport.
We're featuring Caress Carpet from Shaw Industries. Carpet's so soft it makes you want to take your shoes off to play or even take a nap on the floor. Financing is available. That's at Dalton Direct Carpets, Bloomingdale Road in Kingsport.
Are you experiencing neck pain, back pain, or headaches? Muse Family Chiropractic can help. Dr. Alan Muse provides a complete assessment using state-of-the-art technology to determine the cause of the pain and offers advanced treatments to help you find your way to a healthier, pain-free life. At Muse Family Chiropractic, we provide chiropractic care for the whole family, from newborns to great-grandparents, and we accept most insurances.
At Muse Family Chiropractic, you're not just a patient, you're family.
Call us today at 247-5000.
Tennessee Title Loans.
How's it going?
It's going. How can I help you today?
Well, I have some car issues. I could really use the loan. So,
man, what happened?
Funny, I was just driving along and a horse just came out of the sky. So,
get the cash you need fast with Tennessee Title Loans. Located on East Stone Drive in Kingsport.
Attention, nonprofit organizations. Are you tired of selling candy bars and candles and not able to raise the funds you would like to? For the past 10 years, NWA Smoky Mountain has raised lots of money for many great nonprofit organizations. And you can bring the same fundraising technique to your event. For more information, please call area code 423-773-5449 or area code 423-631-9110. Can't get enough of NWA Smoky Mountain? Do you enjoy watching NWA Smoky Mountain TV and want to see more of your favorite stars? Then I have good news for you. Our website, NWASmokyMountain.com, is the place you need to be for all the exclusive news, exclusive matches, exclusive blogs by your favorite NWA Smoky Mountain stars, and much more.
Low on the abdomen, so to speak.
Oh, what was that? Like a miss from Kincaid. Hammond's blinded right now. No clue where he's at. Vince still hung up on the top rope. Oh, now Travis Lee's up. Travis Lee's got him. We've got Nick Hammond's in that fireman's carry. Was it? Oh my God! Wait. Oh! Vince got him! Vince Brent has pinned the Southeastern champion! Vince Brent has won this match. The Cabal have suffered their first loss by pinfall. Jason Kincaid, who has rarely been pinned since winning that Southeastern title 4.5 years ago, But the Cabal is standing tall right now, Coop.
Just taking it out on these individuals, and they cleared the ring of everyone except Vince Brent. This does not look good for Vince.
Now, Vince is definitely in a bad spot right here. With these two giants looming over him, delivering punishment. Kincaid calling for another sacrifice. We know what that means, Coop. We saw it with that light tube on Nick Harrins and their attempt to do the same thing to Raymond Rowe a couple of months ago. This is bad news for Vince Brent. Hammonds is down. Ali is down. There's no one to help Vince Brent, who's just hung out to dry here.
What is he going to do here? He's not going to. Oh, he is.
Double stomp. My God. Vince Brent could have broken ribs. Major internal injuries after that.
He could definitely be severely injured after that.
There you see the face of the Southeastern champion. This malevolent mastermind of the cabal. What do they have in mind here? Oh, come on now. Enough is enough.
No, not again. Come on.
Enough is enough. You've made your point, Kincaid. Does it again. Good God.
Okay, this is enough.
And this is what happens after the cabal lose their first match. And they're still able to dominate like this. Vince Brent needs medical attention. We need to get security or somebody out there to break up this assault. No.
No, they can't be going to go.
Not a third time.
I don't know what to say about this.
Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, Jace Kincaid. A few hours is all you have left, Jason. I'm looking you dead in the eye, and I hope you're watching. You've counted up. For the past 4 years, you've defeated Johnny Nitro, Sabu, Matt Sydal, Chase Owens, Chris Richards. I've seen all the things you've put Nick Hammonds through, and he's still standing. The worst mistake that you're going to do tonight is if you even give me a chance to be standing up. Because I'm going to tell you something. The last breath of air. That's all I'm going to need. That's all I'm going to need, Jason. I've been waiting so long for this, Jason. The time has come. The countdown's ending. As soon as that bell rings tonight, the reign is over. And the new era starts of the Outlaw.
The time for talking's over. Tonight at the Civic Auditorium, two men go to war. One Godzilla versus the best around.
Tonight, the Kingsport Civic Auditorium, I'm not coming alone to face the giant. Found the partner, Notorious Nick Hammonds, Ali Shabazz. You're looking at the future United States champion.
Tonight. John Skyler, it's finally here. You make your debut at NWA Smoky Mountain.
Hello, Mr. Schultz. It's me, Mr. Cruz. Tonight, Kingsport Civic Auditorium, this is going to be just like it was last time, but the outcome, I promise, will be different.
That's right, Nick Hammonds, you have said it! Tonight, we're going to be the new United States Tag Team Champions because we're going to take down the two biggest jive guppies I have ever seen. And to end it off, we both know what their status is. Lame.
tomorrow is Valentine's Day. So everybody watching at home, why don't you do yourself a favor? Why don't you get your lady, if you're a lady, why don't you get your man, and you come on out to a great night of professional wrestling action, because I guarantee you, that's what you're getting here at Smoky Mountain, and I guarantee you, when you watch Chase Owens versus John Skyler, that's exactly what you're gonna get. The two of the very best. Two of the guys traveling everywhere. John Skyler, tonight, we see who the better man is.
Today's the day, Vincent. Today's the day. Are you gonna win?
Are you gonna end the rain? Or are you gonna get rained on?